Residents of Nee Soon, good evening. This general election, this fight, is not only about seats in our parliament. It is about the soul of our democracy. There are two different versions of what our soul should be like. On the one side is the PAP, setting out national programs, local programs, and promising good governance, like first-class education, housing, transport, clean government, good jobs, increased growth, and more. Basically, efficient, clean government, logical, rational. On the other side is the opposition. It does not deal with governance. The opposition does not tell you what they will do or that they can do it better than the PAP. Instead, they appeal to the emotions to fuse together different types of unhappiness. The majority of the people we meet, know the difference. They accept that the opposition has no serious plans on what they can or will do. But some of the people also tell us something which is important and which we must listen to. They tell us Singaporeans know the statistics. They know that Singapore has done well with the PAP government. They know the PAP government has been efficient. But they also tell us, you know, that is not enough. They tell us, people want to know, you empathize with us. You know how we feel. You understand when we feel frustrated, when we feel upset. Some also tell us, our head says the PAP, but we wish you can do more to appeal to our heart as well. My friends, this is a powerful message. It requires us to communicate better. The soul of our democracy must be one which cherishes good governance, but also empathizes, appeals to the spirit of our people, and places in front and center the need for government to connect well with the people. So far, Singaporeans, you have given your trust to the PAP. Because of this trust, the government has been able to plan long-term, long-range, to choose the most logical plans. Then it has been made possible for Singapore to be extremely, exceptionally successful. At the same time, my friends, I hope that the way the opposition has been campaigning will not come to define our politics. In this general elections, the opposition has offered no substantive policy alternatives. Instead, their primary campaign approach has been to stoke up anger, disaffection. No attempt to debate policies in a larger context. And when they do, their policies make no sense. Look at the criticisms, for example. Immigration. They keep saying, too many foreigners. Repeated over and over again. Number of foreign workers, PR, citizens. It's all public information. How many is too many? How exactly will they cut back? They never say that. Most people accept we have to strike a balance. Thus, the key question is, how do we strike that balance? What the numbers should be? The debate should focus on that question. In Parliament, it was shown that the more foreign workers came in, when the economy grew, companies needed more workers. Our local workers' wages also grew the fastest when the economy grew. The opposition's MPs in Parliament did not say that this is untrue. But here at the general elections, they try and translate the unhappiness with foreigners into votes. In doing so, they are doing a disservice to the voters because they are depriving voters of a proper debate. They don't deal with the trade-offs. If we have less foreign workers, less growth, less industry, SMEs will suffer. Your salaries will go down. So at present, it is a PAP policy versus the opposition rhetoric. My Singaporeans, fellow Singaporeans, there was an issue the Workers' Party tried to debate on GST this year in March. Mr. Lau Tiak Yang said GST should be cut. Mr. Thaman, our foreign finance minister, pointed out 75% of the GST was paid by foreigners and the higher income families. for the lower income families, for every $1 they paid in GST, they got back $5 from the government. GST is a tax mostly paid by the well-off and is used to help the less well-off. At the end of the debate, no answer from Mr. Lau. All his points were shown to be unworkable. He could offer no alternatives. So now Workers' Party does not say much about GST. You can look at the parliament debate yourself. It is very clear. This is why I said this is a fight for our democratic soul. What will it be like? Will we go down the same road like many other countries where emotions are played up for pure political gain, where politics means arguing to work up unhappiness against policies, even if the policies are good in the long term? Just attack, criticize, throw darts. Don't offer any alternatives yourself. The choice is for us to go down that road, or alternatively, we continue to be an exceptional place, performing well above everyone else, constantly pulling ahead, creating a better future for everyone, because we are prepared as a society to work together. My friends, I hope all Singaporeans will take a long, deep, hard look at the specific concrete proposals put forward by the opposition. You will find them largely non-existent. I say largely non-existent. When they put forward proposals, they are somewhere between bad and downright crazy. Two examples. First is the Workers' Party's housing policy. They want to have new flat prices linked to median income. Ministry of National Development has explained clearly that will affect the prices of all HDB flats. All of you who own flats, your flat values will go down. That is the trade-off of the Workers' Party policy. Is that something all of you want? Workers' Party also says no to LUP, HIP, because they are against asset enhancement. Mr. Lau then comes in and tries to limit the damage by saying, well, Workers' Party is not against asset enhancement. People's houses are a serious matter. The policies need to be thought through. Mr. Tanjisay of SDP also has a proposal. Spend $60 billion, he says, is loose change. Of that $10 billion, he says, pay companies in Singapore to go overseas and go out of Singapore and close their companies in Singapore. He says, close down Shanmugam shipyards and Keppel shipyards. Lose 500,000 jobs, most of which are Singaporean. Lose 2,000 Singaporean jobs from Shanmugam shipyards alone. And in return, he says, we will rely on the good wishes of our neighbors, neighboring countries, to let us do their service work. You believe that? I have only one word to describe that policy. It's crazy. So we have attacks based on stoking up emotion and crazy proposals. My friends, let us reject this empty rhetoric. Let us keep to the path that has worked. Let us remain an exceptional place, providing a better future for all. Some Singaporeans have asked a legitimate question. Why not have some opposition MPs in Parliament? Say 5 to 10. That won't change our system. We will still have a strong government, and the opposition MPs will keep the government on its toes. There are many responses to this. Let me give you the central one. An elected MP does two things. One, he looks after the constituency, plans upgrading, helps people by working with various government agencies. He runs MPS, he runs welfare programs, basically does his best for his constituents. In addition, the MP raises issues in Parliament, constituency as well as national issues, questions the government in Parliament. These two functions, our system allows you to separate them. You choose an MP who will best look after your constituency's interests, and at the same time, there will be a minimum of 9 opposition MPs who, together with the other MPs, will question the government. In addition, there will also be 9 MPs. So there will be a total of 18 members of Parliament who are not from the PAP, at the minimum, to ask questions, to probe, to ask for information, to make speeches, like Ms. Sylvia Lim did in the last parliament. Questions raised in this general election can be raised in parliament by these MPs. So the answer to the point is that the point that there needs to be opposition voices in parliament, the short answer is there will be 18 of them, of whom at least 9 will be from the opposition. They are the people's choice of opposition MPs based on votes. So for every voter, the real question is, who do I want taking care of my estate and me? 9 opposition candidates will get into parliament in any event, regardless of what happens. So vote for the team which can best take care of the country and your estate, your jobs, your future. Let me now say a few words about Nee Soon. Residents of Nee Soon GRC, consider what the Workers' Party offers you. Their main slogan is that they want to bring back the kampung spirit. Nothing else. What does this phrase mean? It is to mask the absence of any meaningful platform, policies, lack of ideas. They come, they present themselves to you, and they say, I want to bring a kampung spirit, and please vote for me. Your lives are going to depend on that. Your neighborhood is going to depend on that. You think they can look after you if they haven't even thought about what policies they will put in place even before they offer themselves as candidates? They go back to 40, 50 years ago, but Yishun has moved on since then. It's a bustling town now. Services, facilities, and we look to the future, not the past. They say, vote us and we will decide. On nomination day, Dr. Poli Guan, one of the Workers' Party candidates, was asked by the media what his plans were. Look it up on the website. He had no answer. We will send to every house in Nee Soon his answer. You can see it for yourself, and it will show that they have no policy, that they have no plan, that they have no idea. Nee Soon voters, my team and I ask you, you consider the vision we have set out. You know we have honestly tried our best over the years to work for you and to help you. And the results of our work are obvious. We will continue to work, if elected, for your interests and for Nee Soon to make it an even better place for all of you. We ask for your strong support, and we promise to give you our best and help transform Yishun. Vote PAP. Majalah PAP. Majalah Singapura. Thank you.